heaviest members of the Group 13, gallium, indium and thallium, came to light in the short period of 1860 and 1875, being first detected by spectroscopy analysis of the emission spectrum of metal salts heated in a gas flame. Thallium was the first element discovered in 1861 by William Crookes in London, although it was first isolated a year later by Claude Auguste Lamy. It took its name for the green color of this line of its flame spectrum, which resembles the color of the spring vegetation. Thallium derived from Greek word thallos, a budding shoot or twig. Indium, in other hand, was discovered almost immediately in 1863 by Ferdinand Reich and Hieronymus Richter in Germany. They named the element from the brilliant indigo blue line in this flame spectrum. They were able to obtain the oxide of the element that was subsequently reduced to the metal by heating in that stream of hydrogen. Finally, gallium was discovered by Paul-Émile Lecoq de Bosbaudran in Paris several years later, in 1875. Although the element had been predicted by Dmitri Mendeleev some years before in 1870. Mendeleev named the predicted element as Ica aluminum, and after the discovery of Bosbaudran was finally named gallium in honor of Francs. The three elements present a low abundance in crust earth in accordance with the progressive decrease in nuclear stability of the elements that follow iron. However, gallium, although is very much less of abundant than aluminum, is twice as abundant as boron. Nevertheless, its extraction is more difficult than that for boron because the metal is widely distributed in several minerals, but is not the major constituent of any of them. All the three heaviest metals tend to occur in sulfide minerals rather than oxide, as happened with the lighter elements of the group. Though gallium also occurs as oxide and is found as an impurity in bauxite, being normally recovered as a byproduct of the manufacture of aluminum. Gallium minerals such as gallite, copper and gallium disulfide are rare and have no practical importance. Gallium also occurs in association with zinc or germanium, its neighbors in the period, in some minerals such as zinc blend or the red germanite, where it can be found in the highest concentration. The usual procedure to obtain gallium metal as a byproduct of bauxite consists on a liquid-liquid extraction from the Bayer liquor solution with oxyquinoline as extracting agent. The process is followed by re-extracting back the metal to an aqueous media, and then solution is concentrated. The process of concentration is key in order to permit a greater net accumulation of the metal. Finally, the solution is electrolyzed and the metal can be purified by some melting to a very high purity. Indium, as gallium, is widely distributed but in minute amounts in several minerals, and its concentration is comparable to that of silver. It is commonly associated with zinc ores such as sphalerite, although it is also present in lead, copper and tin ores. Indium is recovered by electrolysis of concentrated solutions obtained by leaching with acids the residues of metallurgical treatment of zinc and lead ores. Finally, thallium, as happened with indium and gallium, is widely distributed and is easily extracted from sulfide minerals, although it can also be found in a rare mineral named crookesite, named after Sir William Crookes. It is usually obtained as a byproduct in the rusting of zinc blend or lead sulfide ores. Thallium is collected in flow dust in the form of oxide or sulfate. After the necessary enrichment of the flux dust in the content of thallium by dissolving it in water dilute sulfuric acid. Subsequently, precipitation as thallium 1 chloride and electrolysis leads to the pure metal. That's all about the extraction of these three metals. In the next video, we will discover some of their important applications and their role in our daily life.